Jay Haynes for the Film Sensei YouTube channel. Today in this video, we are going to do this Umbrella Academy transportation effect in HitFilm Express. So I will be using the free version of HitFilm Express 12, and this is, as of this recording, the most updated version of HitFilm Express. The first thing I did was I had to decide if I wanted to do this the way I've seen all the other tutorials done, which none of them are done in HitFilm, but they all used rotoscoping, and I decided I didn't want to do any rotoscoping. So I went out and set up a green screen and then got ready to do the shot, immediately walked my face right into the bracket that was holding the green screen up, causing a massive gash under my eye. I had to spend the next 20 minutes then getting the bleeding to stop so that I could come out and finally get this 5-second green screen shot. The sacrifices we make for our craft. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a new composite shot, and I'm going to make it only 5 seconds, and I will call this green screen footage, maybe? Okay. And I'm just going to bring in my green screen, and I'm going to bring it on over here until I feel like it's about where I want it to be. Yeah, that's about right. And for those of you who saw my how to get a clean green screen key tutorial, link up here in the corner, this is the same footage. This is the project I was working on, so it's just going to look very similar, but I'm going to do this very quickly, starting by creating the garbage mat, and then add the green screen key. And because I did all that stuff that I did in the other tutorial, I know the exact number, and there it is. Okay, so that's the footage. I'm going to make a new composite shot, and it'll be the final. And what I'm going to do is just bring in a background, which I shot as soon as I was done. Okay, here it is, and leaves are falling and all that kind of stuff. And then I'm going to bring in my green screen footage standing in front of it. And basically, I just sort of step towards the camera. All right. Now, the background footage, I'm going to add a bulge effect to so I can get that little effect. I don't even know how you spell that. But if you want, you can turn on the closed caption and find out how I ended up spelling that. So I want it to be a little bit bigger than normal. So I'm going to make it about 105. That way, when I do the bulge effect, it will, it won't stretch and be obvious in there. Basically, that's one of the three things that has to happen is that bulge effect. The other two things involve this. One is I need to kind of slide in through a slit in the time-space continuum. And then also, I need to have this outline around me at the same time. So we're going to start by creating the sliding in part. To do that, I'm going to duplicate my footage, and I'm going to cheat. Again, you could just rotoscope out the slit that I would slide into, but I'm just going to call this a mask, and I'm going to hide it. I'm going to put it down here. And essentially what I'm going to do is just as I'm stepping through, maybe about here, maybe about there, what I'm going to do is I'm going to transform the scale, and I'm going to make that 0. And then I'm going to move forward about, I don't know, however long it takes for me to step through. And let's go 100 right there. Okay, so basically, I am stepping through this, time-space warp, okay? And so if you look at that, you will see that the slit is just opening up like this, okay? And I like that. That looks pretty cool, right? Yeah, that's wonderful. So what that means is all I have to do is just turn that off. Okay, turn this on, and then I'm just going to use a set matte effect, and I'm going to drop it on the footage and then source the mask. Okay, so what happens now is that as this starts to come through, the slit is sort of opening up. Okay, and I'm sliding through there. So if I were to do a RAM preview, then it sort of looks like this in full speed. Yeah. And I think that that looks pretty nice, you know, and again, I could, you know, work the details of that with my, you know, with an actual mask that I was, you know, keyframing, but that's good enough for me. I'm actually very happy with that. So that's the first part. Then the second part will be creating the outline. So what I'm going to do is the mask, I'm going to duplicate that and I will bring it on top. And what I want to do is I want to add several things to that mask. Turning it on, I want to be able to see it. The first thing I want to do is I want to make it into a white outline. So to do that, I'm going to use the Mac Cleaner. And I'm just going to say, turn on the matte. So now it's this big white outline. Okay. Then if I use a Find Edges effect, I have now just the edges of it. Okay. If I then put a Demult key over it, now I have these edges around and I can go and turn on my underneath footage and you can see. And then last but not least, I can add, well, not exactly last but not least, but for this piece, and a neon glow effect. And so now I have that glow and, you know, I really can just sort of get rid of the radius. All I really want is and I can probably take the intensity up and just sort of drop this down. Actually, I think maybe a little bit of radius might be okay. Yeah, I just want enough, right, where there's this glowing edge that's around, okay? Now, if you own Pro, or if you have the Light Effects Pack 2, then you can use Light Rays, and Light Rays is beautiful. It's just stunningly beautiful, in fact, but it puts the little marker on here because this is the free version, right? But just if you did have it, and let me just, you know, sort of move the position here, and you can see that if I put that there and then I put another one over here, you know, I could get that same exact, you know, very beautiful, you know, sort of light rays that shine off as he's moving through the teleportation effect, but I don't have that. So what I'm going to do instead is I'm going to use the zoom blur effect. The light rays is really nice because it will give you the opportunity to just simply use one masking here. But since I don't have that, I'm going to go ahead and just do this. And then I'm going to move this over here. Okay. So now it's like right here on the edge. Okay. And then if I duplicate that edge or that footage, then if I go to the effects and the zoom blur, I can move this one over to the other side. And I might feel like adding a few more, but I think that will look okay. And if I did a RAM preview, it'd look like this. Yeah, and that looks pretty good. Now at the end of the effect, when I'm fully through that, then I want to go ahead and turn off all those masks. So what I would do is I would just sort of look to see where, let me just kill those for a second, where my, original mask, if I come to that spot, basically that's where these two things are going to end. So I'm just going to end them here both. And in fact, I could, get away with not even starting them until, you know, needed be as well. And for that matter, I don't even need the green screen footage. So, you know, I'm just sort of cleaning this up a little bit here, you know, so now everything is there. And then as I just sort of frame step through, oh wait, let me turn back on my other two. As I frame step through, you can see that I have that sort of slip, you know, effect with the lighting and all that kind of stuff. And I would spend probably more time dialing that in. You know, I think I do want to add one more frame to that just at the very, very end. Yeah, like that. Okay. All right. So that's the second factor. And then the third thing is that bulge effect. I want to go ahead and just turn off all these to start with. Come here to the background, find the bulge effect and drop it on. Okay. Now, what I want to do is I'm going to come back to right here at the end just turn on the green screen footage for a second. The bulge effect is really nice because you can move it around, and it even has these little handles, you know, so that you can really adjust these to exactly where you want. You can have a little bit of a plateau in the middle, which I think is makes it look wonderful. Maybe 30% or so. Okay. And then what's going to happen is that before I show up, it's actually going to bulge in. Okay. So it's going to start at zero, right? And maybe about like, you know, there it starts at zero. And then we move forward a few frames. And now, you know, just before I'm getting ready to come in, it is sucking back. And then as I'm stepping through, maybe I'll turn that on. As I'm, you know, maybe as I'm entering out, now it's sort of popping forward. And then maybe not that much. And then it's going to come back, a little ricochet action. And then it'll come forward, a little ricochet. And then it's at zero again, right? Okay, so if I do a RAM preview, that bulge effect sort of looks like this. And that looks okay, I think. What do you think? I think that looks pretty good, right? So then when I add back in everything else, oh, except for the mask, we don't want that. The mask is just exactly what that is. And I do a RAM preview on the whole thing, it looks like this. Yeah, and that looks pretty cool. Now, if I'm not happy with how the bulge is working, I can always change those keyframes. And the way that I would do that would be to open this up, grab them all, and then while holding down the Alt key, you can stretch those out or squinch those in a little bit. So I think I will just stretch those out a bit. And when it's done, it looks something like this. So pretty much in a nutshell, that's what we're doing here. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave them in the comments below. Like and subscribe if you like this kind of stuff. And hey, thanks for watching.